Subscribe and click the bell icon for the latest updates and notifications from the Indian Express.
Lured by the music, Gul exclaimed, "Wow!" When someone repeated after her, she inquired, "Who is it that speaks now?" A kiki, another cuckoo, whatever Gul spoke, a drongo uttered them too. A kiki, cuckoo. Hi, I'm Devangana Dash. I'm a book cover designer and a visual artist in Delhi. Went to Bandipur National Park in Karnataka, and I was really fascinated by the variety of birds that I saw there. It was monsoon, and I heard the sounds in the jungle, and I was like, okay, there's a way to introduce kids to nature like this. And so I think my starting point with the birds and everything became the sounds of the jungle started from Bangalore. Listening to the lyrical songs, Gul wished to sing too. So she raised an alarm with the pita bird with a ringing weetu on cue. Weetu! Weetu! Birds are all around us, and kids mostly, these days, their entire educational medium has become screens. They're not listening enough and they're not seeing enough, and the world of birds is so colorful, and it's so diverse, because there are all kinds of birds, all kinds of sizes, shapes, colors, all kinds of sounds. So I thought that in this way kids can look at birds around them. Ruffling his feathers, a hoopoe who wanted to join this game flicked his fan and shook his crown and called out his own name. Hoopoo-poo, hoopoo-poo. It's a very meditative and calming sound when I hear birds. But at the same time, there's so much drama when you hear a bird sound. Also, when you listen to alarm calls that these hornbills make, or a bunch of babblers when they're noisy and you really want to shut them up sometimes. But it's all so interesting. A kookal entering the mimics show was surprised on hearing his own call. A loud goop and a loop, for whatever the drongo heard, he stole it all. Goop, 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 goop. I think it's important for all the parents to just take their kids outdoors more, and let them play with sand and mud, and just soak in the world around them, because at the end of the day they need to know what's around them. And I think we are protecting them too much. We're protecting them, putting them in the AC rooms too much, because the schools are now air conditioned, everything is air conditioned. I think they need to step out and see what's around them, what's the world made of.